Good morning, children. So nice to meet you all on this platform once again. Before we start our today's lesson, shall we look to the Lord in prayer? Lord, I love you, Heavenly Father. We thank you for this great time that you've given to us. Lord, we thank you for your being awesome God to us. Lord, we thank you for your presence in our lives. In spite of this pandemic, oh God, you have been protecting us. Lord God, this morning time, I commit these little hearts into your hands. Pray that, Lord, even as I bring your word unto these little hearts, that you will speak to them, O Father. Speak through me, O Father. Lord, use me as your vessel, O Father, that the word will go to them as a double-edged sword, and they will know you and come closer to you and honor you, Lord. Lord, I pray for every one of them who is sick. Pray for their families too, O Master. Reach out to them in their point of need. We thank and praise and worship you for this time that you've given to us. We give you all the glory. Be with us, Lord. Take complete control over the rest of the time. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Yes, kids. Hope all of you are doing good. Well, staying safe at home. This morning time, I would want you all to look at this, the picture which is put on the screen. What do you all understand from that? Do you get to, some of you have a, you get scared to see that syringe. You don't like to take injection, right? So can I know, but why do we even have to take an injection? It's painful. But when we are sick, we tend to take it. Knowing it is painful because we would be relieved from that sickness. Well, let's see the next slide. It tells this beautiful girl, wearing braces to her teeth, which is also very painful. It's not easy to maintain those braces. Some of you might have had an experience of using it. It's not that easy. A lot of maintenance, a lot of pain that we have to undergo, right? So, but why do we use it? Because we know that these braces will straighten our teeth and will make us look good and beautiful. Well, as we look at this next part, there's a boy who's gymming there. Yeah, he wants to, tune his body properly. Rather, he wants to maintain a proper structure, or he wants to lose his weight. No doubt it requires a lot of discipline. There are a lot of restrictions in foods that they take. They have to maintain certain timings, right? So all these things, in spite of knowing that it is difficult for them, still they go ahead, still they move on. Why? Because for a better way, better life, or for a better look, or for something better. But how are we connected to this, to our lesson, today's lesson? Yes, kids, we have a God. We have the Son of God, Jesus Christ, knowing that he had to give his life for our sins. He had come to this earth, lived a beautiful life on this earth, an exemplary life, and he had to take the cross. Do you think it is easy, children? Not at all. So today's lesson talks about Jesus dying for us. He died for us. He took up our infirmities. He took up our sins. Right? So as we meditate upon this word, I just want you all to understand that those days when Jesus was alive, the Jewish leaders and many people in that place, they did not believe in God. They were always after Jesus. They were waiting for Jesus to put him to death. But then why do you think that they were waiting? Did Jesus do anything wrong? Was he a murderer? Was he a person who hurts everybody? No, he doesn't do that. But why is it that they were after Jesus to kill him? Because he was doing everything that was right. They didn't like. He was healing the sick. He was releasing people from, demon possessed. And he only proclaimed what God wanted him to do. And there was a point of time when Jesus said that he is the Son of God. And these Jewish leaders did not like it. How can he say that he is a son of God? How can he proclaim that he is a son of God? They didn't like it. But all that Jesus was doing is the will of God. He wanted people to realize that he is not earthly king. Rather, he was heavenly king sent by the Father. So they didn't like this. So this was a charge against Jesus. They didn't like the way he told that he was a son of man. And this Jewish governing group is called as Sanhedrin. And it was led by Caiaphas, the high priest. So he was dragged, he was taken to Caiaphas, where he couldn't find anything wrong in what Jesus did. And so he could not resolve the problem. He could not give up Jesus to the hands of these Jewish people to put him to death. So he had forwarded this case of Jesus to the Roman emperor. In those days, the Roman governor, I can say, Roman governor was Pilate. So when Jesus was taken to Pilate and the same charge was put against him, saying he has blasphemed that he is the Son of God. Apart from that, Jesus had done nothing. And what he said was also not wrong. He was speaking the truth, whereas people didn't realize the truth. And moreover, they were charging against Jesus, right? So they wanted Caiaphas had forwarded him to Pilate, and Pilate wanted the Jewish people to show some evidences, the Sanhedrin to show evidence. They could not provide any evidence because there was nothing that Jesus had done, right? So Pilate said, okay, then I cannot do anything. You want to resolve this case on your own, you can. But you know, the Jewish people, no matter what, they were determined to put Jesus to death. And what is the point here? Roman law didn't allow Jesus to be put to death, or Roman law didn't allow the Jewish Sanhedrin to put anyone to death. So they kept pressurizing Pilate to declare or to give a judgment of putting Jesus to death. So Pilate told the Jewish leaders, that he couldn't find any evidence that Jesus was wrong. And, but he also knew that Jewish leaders were not going to give up on Jesus. No matter what, they wanted Jesus to be put to death. Right? And so just to satisfy these leaders, Pilate just gave them a choice. It's like they were in those days during the time of Passover, they can release a prisoner or they can release a person, like whoever has done some mistake and he was a criminal kind. So he said he had given them a choice, like as this is the season of the Passover, would you want Jesus to be released, or there was a local criminal or prisoner who is very bad, who was a murderer, Barabbas, who was called as Barabbas, to be released. So Pilate thought that Jews would, at least knowing that Jesus had not been wrong in any of the matters, Pilate thought that Jewish leaders would ask Barabbas to be put to death and Jesus to be released. But guess what? They didn't want Jesus to be released no matter what. And still Pilate didn't want Jesus to die. So still trying to avoid a decision on what has to happen, Pilate attempted to calm the Jews by having Jesus scourged or severely whipped. He thought the Jews might be satisfied to see Jesus being tortured very badly physically. But do you think that Jews have kept quiet? They haven't kept quiet. They wanted Jesus to be put to death. They have fixed a crown like, spiny thorns against his head. They have pressed it across the head of the Jesus. The soldiers put a purple robe onto Jesus. They started calling him King of Jews. They were mocking him. He was spitting. And when we all, tell about Jesus dying for us, we tend to leave out most of the details, children. But can you imagine the pain that would be suffered by us if we just by mistake touched the pointed edge of a pin or a needle? It's so very painful. So imagine Jesus taking that, you know, the spiny crown on his head, which is the sensitive part, the blood shed out of his body. There was no energy in his body. So in spite of being punished, the Jewish leaders were not very happy. No matter what, they wanted Jesus to be put to death. This is what, even one way or the other, even we do in our lives, children. We know our mistakes, but we don't tend to turn towards Jesus. In spite of knowing that we are guilty, still we don't accept Jesus. Just think of the pain that he has taken. He's not a sinner, but why should he take our sins? He was obedient to his Father. His Father sent him on a mission, and he was determined to complete it. Even in the final point of death, he did not give up. He was obedient to his Father for the call that he has given to him. The crowd were not satisfied. Jesus had to wear the crown of thorns and the purple robe as Pilate had presented him to the Jews. He hoped they would be satisfied. They were not satisfied. And Pilate told the Jews he could find no fault in Jesus. This time he also emphasized that, you know, if Jesus is going to be crucified, then it would be the Jews and the Jewish leaders who would be responsible for his death. You know what Pilate has done? He didn't want to take the blame upon himself. Though he was the ruling authority, he did not tell the Jewish people, no matter what, it cannot happen because there is no evidence. He couldn't declare that. Rather, he gave up, you know, Jesus, and he said, you know, because the people were screaming and mocking and shouting, he just gave up on Jesus. He could not declare that Jesus was of no sin. And he was remembered for this for almost 2000 years or more than that, for giving his wrong judgment. But according to God, it had to happen, children. It had to happen. So our memory verse also tells the same thing. If you can see on the screen here, it's from Romans chapter 5 verse 8. God shows his love for us in that while we were all sinners, Christ died for us. Though we were sinners, he died for us. Shall we look up onto the cross? Shall we look at the sacrifice made by our Lord? Shall we value every drop of blood which is pierced out of his body? He was asked to carry that heavy cross. He had to walk for a distance with that kind of a body which was beaten, which was pierced, where nails were pierced into his body. So kids, shall we look at the sacrifice of Jesus seriously? Shall we take it to our hearts? And shall we come out of any kind of sin which is, you know, haunting us, which we are drowned in? Even a single lie that we would use when somebody questions us about something, cheating, backbiting, back answering. Shall we give up all these things, and shall we live a life which is pleasing to God, which will be a great blessing to all of us? John, the writer of this account, doesn't go into a lot of detail about Jesus. If you look at John chapter 19 verse 18, it says Jesus was crucified. What does it mean to you and me that he was crucified? When we read the Bible, and when we especially celebrate the Good Friday and the Easter Sunday, all that we would know is, yes, Jesus died for our sins. He was mocked, he was bruised. They have pierced nails into his hands, blood shed out of his body. And he rose again on the third day. Is this what we know about it? What does it mean, sacrifice? More than his bodily, physical pain that Jesus had undergone, he was worried about us. He didn't want us to fall into sin. He just wanted us to rise out and rise out from the sin forever, not looking back. That is what Jesus wanted from all of us kids. When you look at John chapter 19 verses 28 to 30, even at the last minute of his death, when he felt so tired and when he was so, you know, thirsty, when he asked for a drink, then you know what the soldiers had offered, not having mercy upon Jesus. They dipped a sponge in wine vinegar and stuck it on a branch of the hyssop plant and offered it to Jesus. That plant product is nothing but so sour. You cannot, it's so bitter, I can say. The moment you put it in your mouth, it like you try to vomit it out. That's how horrible it would be. And even then, Jesus wanted God to forgive all the sins of the mankind. And he gave his last breath saying, "It is finished." Boys and girls, shall we all ask God for his forgiveness? Even though when we were sinners, he died for us. Christ died for us knowing that we are sinners. I know small little things will matter a lot. What you start getting a habit of from now on would help you to lead a life which is pleasing to God. Jesus paid every debt of sin that anyone in the world, either in the past, present or in the future, ever owed to God. Jesus rose to life again. All that's left for us to do is to believe in Jesus, to carry his cross, to live a life which is pleasing to him. Shall we all, children, decide and take a, you know, very strong decision that we will never give into sin. We will always walk in his paths, no matter how difficult it is. Yes, it's not easy to walk in his paths, but you can ask God. You can ask God of his strength. You can ask him of his love and his power of the cross. So that power of cross will help you live a life which is pleasing to God. Will you all memorize the verse, children? Romans chapter 5, verse 8. God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Shall we remember these words and carry it in our hearts as we live a life which is pleasing to God? Shall we all look to the Lord in prayer? Lord, we thank you for this lesson. Thank you for reiterating to us, Lord, that you died for our sins. Even we were still sinners, though we were sinners, Lord, you died for our sins, O God. We thank you for your sacrifice. Help us, Lord, to lead a life which is pleasing to you, to understand the great sacrifice that you've made for us, and Lord, to give you glory with our lives, and to serve your purpose of sending us onto this earth. We thank you, Lord, praise you and worship you. Bless all these little ones, we pray. In Jesus' precious name, we pray all this. Amen. Thank you, kids. Hope you enjoyed this lesson. God bless you all.